Hello.
What's new with you?
They say that King Hal's... has made an alliance with House Dress. Together they...
Cyrodiil's runestones are thought to belong to one of three types. The Dawn Arrow...
Look, if you're here for information, I'm afraid you'll have to find it on your own. I'm swamped right now, up to my ears in necromancy. Not practicing it, mind you. Wouldn't want anyone to think I was involved in that sort of thing. I simply meant researching it. Why? Oh, no real reason. It's just that the entire Council of Mages has been in here at one time or another recently, all wanting information on necromancers. Necromancy, of all things. Oh, of course you were. No doubt the Council is trying to get you to bother me further. I ran Karanya out of here just a short while ago and told them to leave me alone. I keep telling them I can't produce results if I'm not given any time. I'm not used to working under conditions like this. Now that is a bit more specific. Finally, something I can respond to. Let me think for a moment. Ah, yes, there's one obscure text that references these gems. I believe it's still around here someplace, unless Falkar never returned it. The name of the book is Necromancer's Moon. I'm unclear on the origins of the text, but it does involve these gems you're interested in. I'm afraid you'll have to find it yourself. I'm so out of sorts with all these requests, I've lost track of most everything. It's very distressing. I believe you'll find it quite helpful. Once you've had a chance to read it, I'd be happy to discuss it with you. Why all the fuss now? I thought it would have died down by now, what with the ban on the practice of necromancy in the guild being in place for as long as it has. And yet, suddenly everyone shows up on my doorstep, needing information immediately. Never mind that I might have things on my own to work on. Good day.
Thank you.
have you found? I believe you'll find it quite helpful. Once you've had a chance to read it, I'd be happy to discuss it with you. Good day. It's my pleasure. A most interesting text, is it not? We are fortunate that at least one necromancer took the time to record the information. I am unfamiliar with a shade of the revenant described within the book, but I was never one to dabble in the more, shall we say, amoral arts. You may take that with you for now, if you wish. The council may have use for it. Please, ask them to return it quickly, as I may need it again. Take care.
Hello. Has Tarmina been of use in gathering information about the necromancers?
Excellent work. I believe this will be of use to the Council. I shall make sure they're made aware of its contents.
I've never heard of this Shade of the Revenant. Some sort of celestial phenomenon?
If that's correct, then Bothiel would most likely know something about it, as the caretaker of the Orrery. She should be on university grounds. A most fascinating contraption. Bothiel is one of the few who understands how it worked and kept it running.
Goodbye. Well met. What's new? With you.
I ran across a couple of... Hello there. Is there something I can do? Revenant, you say? And it represents something in the heavens? It sounds familiar. Let me think. Ah, yes. Now I remember. Falcor was here some time ago asking about just such a thing. Said it was for research. He had a large sheaf of notes with him about it. I'm afraid I didn't have any more advice for him than I do for you. With the Ori in such a state of disrepair, I have no point of reference. Falcor did leave this behind. I think it fell from his notes as he left. I didn't pay it much attention, but perhaps it will be of use to you. I've heard things, to be sure, but I don't really know anything about them. Is it true that some of our guildmates were killed? Oh, how horrible!
Greetings, Conjurer.
Good day. So, Falcar expressed interest in this revenant as well, and left this note behind, did he? Perhaps we should look into it for more clues. This lists several locations. The first is the Dark Fissure, which I recognize. It's a cave in the mountains, south of Chadenhall. If there is indeed an altar there, as the note suggests, I believe this cave is directly related to the contents of the book. Go to the Dark Fissure the next time this shade occurs. Search for any connection to what we've learned and report back. Please, be careful. Anything you find is of no use to us if you do not survive. I believe we are dealing with powerful forces here. Do not put yourself in harm's way if it can be avoided. Be careful.
Greetings, wizard.
Hello, Conjurer.
Is everything all right?
Whoa! You will not stop us. The Order of the Black Worm will consume all in its path.
way, damn you!
Ha!
Just warming up, you pathetic worm!
Ha! Yeah!
you're pathetic. Am I supposed to be impressed? You'll never take me down. What's the matter? Getting tired?
Yeah!
Show me what you've got. That's the best you can do?
can do? Die! I'm just warming up, you pathetic worm!
Die, you orc filth! Die!
Ha! Cool! That the best you can do?
Thank you.
Conjurer. Have you been to the Dark Fissure yet? We need to know all we can about the... So you saw them? The altars must be infused with some kind of power to change over the soul gems. I shall pass the news on to the Council. Most troubling indeed to know that these are not merely myths. I also fear their numbers may be greater than we believed. You have again performed admirably. You have my thanks, and that of the Council as well. You are Conjurer no more. Guild members shall now address you as Magician. Congratulations. Seek out Archmage Traven. He has personally requested that you see him for your next assignment. Take care.
I have a feeling that you and I are about to become very... close.
What's new with you?
They say...
Well, greetings. It is high time that we met face to face, don't you think? Raminus has told me good things about you. You have advanced quickly and show great promise. I now intend to put your talents to a more direct test. I have a difficult task that you can, perhaps, assist with. Are you prepared to begin? Very good. Let me explain what is at stake. The Council of Mages has been aware of the increased necromancer activity in Cyrodiil for some time. It had been our position to sit back and watch what unfolded, but that time has clearly passed. We cannot tolerate these attacks on the Guild. Most of our information on the necromancers has come from an informant inside the cult itself, a Guild member who offered to infiltrate their ranks. Lucianus Elias. He is not a council member, but has long served the Guild here at the Arcane University. Aware of the growing interest in the Guild after the ban on necromancy was put into place, he offered to help the Council track the cult's actions. With my blessing, he infiltrated the group, and has fed us information for quite some time, until recently. I have not heard from him, and I fear for his safety. Yes, and we have for quite some time. Though the information he has provided is limited, it has given us a sense of their scope and power. The Council was initially reluctant to believe the information was reliable, but with recent events, they have little choice but to trust it. I fear that our informant is in danger, and that is why I have called you here. The lack of reports from Mucianus has disturbed the Council, and they are now concerned about the legitimacy of his information. A group of battle mages were dispatched to Mucianus's last known location with the intent of bringing him in for questioning. I argued against it, but eventually agreed to maintain order in the Council. I regret that decision, and that is why I wish to send you there. Mucianus last reported being sent to the ruins of Nenyon Twill, south of the Imperial City. That is where the battle mages went. South of the White Rose River, nearly halfway to the border of Elsewhere. I'm afraid I know nothing more about the location or what you may expect to find once you arrive. I fear the battle mages may mistreat Mucianus if they do not mistake him for one of the many necromancers no doubt present in the ruins. I wish for you to find Mucianus and ensure his safe return to the Arcane University. I do not want anything to go wrong. If not already, and time is of the essence. If for any reason they are unsuccessful, Mucianus's life will be in forfeit. You must make sure he is safe. Go now, and bring word to me as soon as he has been escorted to safety. Thank you. Know that I would not ask such a thing of you if I did not feel it was urgent, or that it was beyond your capabilities. I shall await your return. Make haste. Lucianus is in danger.
Hello there.
Greetings, magician.
Please.
You! What are you doing here? Fifthraga, battle mage, sent by the council to find this traitor! He must have told them we were coming. We've got to get our hands on him before he tells them anything else. Who the blazes are you, anyway? Has the council gone mad, sending you here alone? There's no time. The others, they were waiting for us. They knew we were coming. I'm the only one left. The necromancers retreated further in, but we've got to follow them. There's no time to waste. Follow me.
Oh, you poor dear. I'm afraid you're late to the party. The guest of honor has already left. And I do hate to disappoint you, but Mucianus is in no condition to be leaving. He's a worm thrall now, and shall be quite content here. A grim fate indeed, but one does not cross the Order of the Black Worm without suffering greatly for it. I shall tell the master that you were here looking for him. Perhaps I'll bring him your head as an offering.
Ha!
Yeah! Hi!
What news of your... What? By the Nine, and there was nothing you could do for him? What a horrible fate. I cannot imagine how they could do that to him. So many lives lost. I thank you for trying to save him. Before we continue, you should speak to Raminus Polus about your advancement within the guild. Be seeing.
Greetings, magician.
Well met.
Your role within the guild becomes ever more essential. You have now attained the rank of warlock and are freely able to access the council chamber. Your tasks now come directly from Archmage Traven. Please speak with him if you're unsure what you should be doing.
Good day.
There is an urgent matter which requires your personal attention. This task falls to you and only you. Are you prepared to begin? Count Hasseldor of Skingrad has contacted the council. He claims to have information that is vital to us. He has requested that you personally travel to Skingrad to obtain this information. I cannot stress how important it is that our relationship with Hasseldor be preserved. I expect you to visit him immediately. I am unsure as to why he has requested that you, of all people, should be the one to visit him. I have no wish to put you in harm's way. Count Hasseldor.
Hi!
Welcome, Guild Mage. We meet again, although in different circumstances. I fear this time you may find the results no more to your liking than the last. Less so, perhaps. The information I have for your guild will not be met with smiles and handshakes, I fear. I have called you here because, from our previous encounter, I believe you can be trusted. Consider the implications of that as you handle a small matter for me. Surprised? Nothing is for free, Mage. There is a small nuisance I would have you deal with before I tell you what I know. One good turn deserves another, after all. It is a minor situation, to be sure, but neither I nor my guards can become directly involved. East of the town. They are a threat to the town and must be eliminated. Their presence has drawn a group of vampire hunters to town, following rumors of vampires in Skingrad. While I do not believe my identity has been compromised, I do not wish to take any chances, and so cannot act on either matter. You, however, can act with impunity, and so will take care of this for me. Then, I will tell you what I know. What do you wish to know about it? The cavern is a short distance east of the castle, far enough from town that few residents have reason to pass by it, thankfully. I assure you, I am not responsible for them. I would never be so careless. Where there are mindless animals, predators are never far behind. This is not the first time such a thing has happened, however. On some level, they're aware of my presence. Whether they covet all that I have or simply wish to see it destroyed, I do not know. They have given in to their instincts and are little more than animals. They need to be exterminated, one way or another. Very well. A troublesome lot. I expect you to deal with them. There are at least three of them. I know only one by name, a wood elf, called Eridor. He's rather good from what I understand. I could handle them myself, but it would be unwise to display my prowess in public. That is the folly of the young and proud. Of course, should you be caught murdering them in the streets, the guards will respond accordingly. I can't be connected with this, remember? This I cannot say. I have refrained from expressing too much interest, lest their attention be turned towards the castle. The citizens will likely know more. I imagine many have noticed their presence here. Kill them. Run them out of town. Do what you will. I simply want them gone. Of course, should you be caught murdering them in the streets, the guards will respond accordingly. I cannot arouse further suspicion by offering leniency to you, should you find yourself on the wrong side of the law. Very well.
I shall await your return.
Thank you.
A little bird told me that you've been asking around town about Glarther, a resident eccentric. I'd like to know why. Let me give you some advice. Glarther is crazy. So far, harmless crazy. But I keep an eye on him because it's my job to. You don't want to get involved with him. I don't care how much he's paying you, it isn't worth it. Like I said, he's crazy. Since you're courteous enough to tell the truth, I'll do the same by trusting you to talk to a guard if he asks you to do anything strange. Why do you bother me? Go away.
Well met.
Can't be seen talking. I waited for you last night behind the great chapel. Where were you? I'll meet you there tonight.
Yes, the Gold Road does pass through Skingrind. I, too, find it
Fascinating!
We can't be seen talking. I waited for you last night behind the great chapel.
Yes.
Hurry. I'm Ma. My sister, Ugakra. A smelly lot, if you ask me. They're in here to eat every afternoon and bed down just before midnight. Outside of that, it's none of my business. Just leave!
Hello? Who's there?
Oh. Yeah! Yeah.
Come to me, sweet.
Worship has become increasingly prevalent in the Somerset Isle.
The Arkwright have a powerful presence. It could be a dangerous situation.
How are you?
Thank you. That's
fair.
Thanks for us.
Look who we've got here.
Yeah!
Where are you?
Oh!
I'm just warming up, you pathetic worm.
Safe travels.
Bye.
Huh? How much?
Pia!
Come to me, sweet flesh.
Oh.
What's the matter?
Ooh.
Getting tired?
Yeah! Oh! Yeah! Yeah!
Quickly now.
Why do you bother me? Go away.
How goes it? Well met. I've heard some strange stories about...
You have completed your tasks for the Count, have you not? Then...
I've heard rumors about him, but I don't believe they're true.
Is that so?
We're all talking.
Thank you.
For the love of Azura, can't a man have a bit of privacy? Get out of here!
I think you should leave.
So the work?
The cavern is silent once more.
Your gift, the necromancers, while I do not know, merely see to it. I've told you, he is an old and powerful necromancer.
Return to your guild and prepare yourself accordingly.
What is it, citizen?
What news? What? Is that possible? This is grave news indeed. I had, perhaps foolishly, believed that necromancy was all but stamped out in Cyrodiil. It seems I couldn't have been more mistaken. I shall need to consult the council as to how to proceed with this situation. Thank you for the information. It may save many lives. My attention is focused on the council right now. My attention is focused on...
Hello. A pleasure to... Take care.
How are you? Greetings.
Good tidings, sir.
I hope...
Farewell.
Greetings and salutations.
Yeah. Yeah! Yeah. Yeah! Hiyah!
Ha! Yeah!
Who?